My name is Lightness, and this is
Prisca.
We will introduce ourselves more as more people sign up. Since we still have 2 minutes until the yellow couch session begins.
How was your Friday?
Well, now it's looking better because it's closer to 5. You know, but you know, in the morning I kind of felt. It's Friday, but it felt like Monday. You know how it is.
We work with things.
Yeah, like Friday is like Monday. How's your Friday going?
Going good.
Busy.
But spending time to have a good few.
Thank you so much for your time, Prisca. I appreciate it. I'm sure everybody else will once they log on. So maybe as we wait, we can do something really fun, like, do you have a few people logged on already? Okay, great. So, before we begin, maybe we can do something fun, like I said. So, everybody just, if you've logged on, can you just take, copy the link to this video. Think of anybody who has told you about, can you help me to create a CV, you know? Can you help me to make up, I don't know, make up stuff on my CV so I can get a job. This is the time that you can share a video of us speaking about how to make a best CV and they don't have to buy them anymore. So let's just take that one moment. I'm going to do it too. Take the link to the video and just send it to that one person or to that group that is always bugging you about their CV.
Someone is telling you I'm looking for a job.
Exactly.
This is what you should share.
Yeah. Once I have that link, I am going to share it. Have you sent the link?
Yeah.
You do the same. People, guys, I'm also doing the same. Okay, so I am almost done. There we go.
What's the joining status?
Done. Okay, so maybe let's formally introduce ourselves now. My name is Lightness. I am a senior project coordinator here at Empower. This is the very first of our yellow couch sessions, hence the yellow couch, because we're fun like that. So we're going to discuss different topics every week. This week we're going to talk about how to win with your CV, how to have the perfect CV, and as the weeks go on, we'll have different topics as well, very interesting topics, but this is the first one. So I'm joined by my awesome, awesome colleague here. She's going to introduce herself right about now.
Yes. My name is Prisca Michael, and I'm a project coordinator here at Empower. And I do training, facilitation, but also recruitment. So today we are talking about CVs and how best we can win, how best we can go out there and represent ourselves.
Yes.
I'm honored to be here.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much for your time, Prisca. So probably maybe we have some people here wondering where do these people work? What is Empower, you know? So for me, Empower is home, obviously, but we are a human capital consultancy firm. We offer a lot of services, one of which is talent. We also do training, we do consulting. Can you think of anything else? Because we do a lot.
We do everything. We also have youth engagement,
yes.
So we have different projects where we reach out to youth. We do advisory, employee engagement. So if you ever think of any human capital needs, we are the company to go to.
Exactly.
Yes.
So also a little bit of housekeeping. We do have a team behind the camera. So if you hear me speaking to a team, it's our beautiful team behind the camera. And other than that, I guess let's begin. So Prisca is going to start us off with a wonderful quote that's going to get us thinking before we actually start our talk show.
You know, we were thinking like, what quote will go with a CV?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I just thought, they say that don't judge a book by its cover.
Mm.
But today, we So you might go out there and say, don't judge me by my cover.
But if you're a candidate, we are going to judge you by your CV.
Exactly.
So think about that.
Yeah. So speaking of CVs and judging you, we are recruiters, so that's literally what we do. We judge you by your CV. So which is what has sparked this conversation today. And Empower has made it even easier for all our registered candidates. If you haven't registered with us, please go to www.empower.co.tz. I can show you that on our cup here. I hope you can see it. If you can't, I've spelled it out. I'll say it again at the end of the video. We have what we have launched. It's called a CV Builder. I mean, guys, it's amazing. Have you used it?
Amazing. I have used it. It's amazing. It is simple to use.
It's so quick.
It's so colorful.
It's orange.
Yes.
It's like orange. And all you have to do is you go. We have different tabs at the top of your profile now. So if you go to the tab at the top right, there's a place there written CV Builder. You click on it. Once you click, you're going to see three different types of CVs. So this is just for us to start with. We'll have more templates as we go. Mm-hmm. So you have three different types of CVs. We have skill-based CVs, and then we also have one for the executives.
Yes.
You know, the board members, CEOs. Mm-hmm. We go for every level. All the way.
Yes.
So all you have to do is pick a template. Right after you pick a template, there is the edit button. It looks like a little pencil.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You just click on it and then you follow instructions. If it's a profile, you write your profile, right?
And the good thing with our CV Builder is we have given you examples. So a lot of people are like, I don't know how to write a good profile. So we've already given a good example of what a good profile looks like, of what things you should put as your skills and achievements. So all you have to do is think about your experience and merge it to the template that is there already.
And then if that's not enough, even while you're writing your profile, besides an example, we actually tell you what to put in your profile. Mm-hmm. Give you tips. Mm. Do this, do that. I'm not going to tell you what the tips are, so you can go and use it for yourself. But then it gives you tips as well. I mean, Empower can't chill, guys. We always think about customers and our clients. So having said that, so I'm hoping that everyone who is registered and logged on to this video is going to use the CV Builder today. I have created my own CV today. Not today, I'm lying. Two or three days ago, I don't remember then. And it's just, it's so fulfilling and easy. Yes. Like at the end, everything just comes together beautifully.
You know what, I thought of something. Mm-hmm. Why don't we do a challenge?
Okay.
Go to CV Builder, go to empower.co.tz, create your CV with the CV Builder. Take a snapshot at the job, because our CV Builder is so good, we'll know it is the one. Just take a snapshot and then post it on LinkedIn.
Yes.
Hopefully you're on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
Post it on LinkedIn with a hashtag CV Builder, hashtag Empower Limited.
Yeah.
And we'll come and check out your profile.
And if you're looking for a job, maybe just post your whole CV. It's also okay.
Yes, we're recruiters.
People can see what you're doing.
Yes.
So that's a good challenge. I think the best part about the CV Builder is that it's free, guys. You don't have to pay a single cent to use the CV Builder. I mean, it's like we've made the food, we've crushed it up, and we are just letting you eat.
What
just please use the CV Builder. Okay, so to get on to the next section, of our talk, we as recruiters see so many CVs, and some CVs make us so happy, and then some of them just make us want to do talks like this. So we are going to just bounce off ideas off each other of what not to put in your CV. I know you've probably heard so many talks on, you know, CV building and all that. So we just want to tell you what not to do, because our CV Builder already tells you what to do, okay? Mm-hmm. So we're going to tell you what not to do. So we're just going to bounce off ideas off each other for all the things that we hate to see in a CV, okay? I'm going to let Prisca start us off. What would the first thing that comes to mind?
First thing I hate on a CV is tables.
Oh my God. Oh yes.
If you wake me up at 2 a.m. and you ask me, Prisca, what do you hate on CVs? I'll say tables. So it's just that someone did not put thought into formatting their CVs and putting it in a good format. And the thing with tables is it just makes your CV unnecessarily long.
Yeah.
Because you have to put stuff in a table, and it's not normal way to write information. Usually you use table when you want to organize a certain type of information.
Yeah.
So it's just that it's a weird. Why would you put tables?
Why would you want to do
it's
that?
It's so hard to navigate.
However, you know, maybe to defend them, if you do want to use a table, then maybe remove the borders so we don't have to see the borders. Then your CV looks really neat.
Yes.
And then we you know, it
makes
looks
sense.
Better
yeah.
than actually using a table and it no, please no. Please don't do that. Right?
Yes.
Yeah. I think another thing that is so annoying is long CVs. It's like
11 pages.
It's almost like you're doing a business plan,
mm-hmm.
but really you're just writing your CV, you know?
Exactly.
And we were saying most in our post that your CV is like your billboard, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
A billboard of yourself.
Yes.
So if you think about Vodacom or think about any company that has billboards in the street,
mm-hmm.
Empower,
mm-hmm.
yeah. What would you want to put on your billboard? You put the most important stuff on the billboard,
yes.
okay? So you want to put what you want other people to know.
Yes.
Now, if you have a CV that's 10 pages and you're only 23 years old, like, there's only a lot you can do at 20, right?
Not that much.
Yeah, it's
not to stop anybody's success, but also
yeah.
it's not only about this is everything I've done for all my life.
Yeah.
I think which will bring me to another point is not to tailor your CV to what you're applying for. So if you're putting everything you've ever done, including
yeah.
carrying a cab and printing some documents,
definitely
your CV is going to do have 11 pages.
Yes.
So you have to think like, okay, which job am I applying for?
Yeah.
And how can I put my duties, my achievement in a strategic way
yeah.
so that these people can really see the highlights of the skills that
yeah.
I have. So you don't need 11 pages to do that.
No, unless maybe like you're a CEO, but even when you are, you can just
CEOs
yeah,
have on pages.
Quite true.
Mm.
Quite true.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. So maybe for us to also just, we're going to keep engaged with you guys. So we have all your chats here. If you see us looking down, it's because you're trying to say hi. So we're going to say hi to all of you. Thank you, Miranda. Yes, we also like the yellow couch.
Yes.
We love it so much. Okay, so another thing that is kind of annoying is like different formatting. It's like your first job, you've used Times New Roman.
Yes.
And then in the middle of your CV, you're like, I think I'm more of a Times New Roman. Maybe
it's
you can
Cambria.
Like, yeah, and then after that, you use Cambria. Okay, these are different fonts for those who don't know what I'm talking about. These are different fonts on Microsoft Word.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're writing your CV, there's a very quick trick you can do. You can click Control A on your computer.
Mm-hmm.
That selects everything, and then just pick one font.
For everything.
And one size.
Yes.
Please.
It just makes it look professional.
You know, yeah.
If you cannot sit down, because when I read this CV, as you say, it's a representation of yourself.
Yeah.
I'm already thinking, if you could not think that I want my work to look neat and
mm-hmm.
organized and the same, how would you be able to do my work? If
I
you are an accountant, how will you be able to keep my mind?
Can
I'm scared.
Being an accountant. The CV that has
different
formats.
Yeah, how would you keep my money? I'm scared. So
yeah.
it's stuff like that which makes people already think you're not a qualified candidate.
Quite true.
That will be a passive builder.
Mm.
You don't have to worry about that.
Yeah.
Because it's automatic, you don't have to think of font, you
yeah.
don't have to think of formatting. We've done all that
for you.
Yes, all you have to think is the information. Yeah. So
yeah.
it's like we've told you, chill, relax, let us take care of the technical bits
mm-hmm.
and look at the strategic part
yeah.
of your CV.
Yeah. I think something else is that we will have a question and answer session, but if you have any questions, you can start posting them now and our team will start connecting them. That's just something else I had to add there. And then another thing, one other thing you hate, I'm just talking about things
yes.
that okay, you're making me look bad. Say
something that I don't like on the CV as well is wrong contacts or information.
Oh my gosh.
And weird emails.
What's the point?
What's the point of sending me your beautiful, nice CV
mm-hmm.
and your number is unavailable and your number is now you don't have NIDA so you're not registered.
Yes,
I did. So they're like, this number, typo, our
yeah.
you are. It really does not make sense.
Yeah.
Or you have an email which is bad boys for life.
At gmail.com.
Rasta 45.
Wow.
No.
Wow.
So this is a professional
Rasta
document.
Okay.
I have another one. Pretty lady. don't. Yeah. It's just no matter how much you don't like your name, it is your name.
Yeah.
Use your name for your email.
It's okay, yeah. Like, just put your name, put a couple of numbers, and then at yahoo.com or at gmail.com or whatever.com.
Service provider you use.
You know? Yeah, and just, you know, a CV is so important, guys. Like, I can't stress it enough. I think maybe because I'm a recruiter, I feel the need to have a good CV, you know? Because it's the first thing that we see before we see you. You know, when you meet someone face-to-face, you can try and convince them that you're a good person or that you are qualified for the position.
Yes.
But if I'm a recruiter and I have 5 roles that I'm working on, and I have deadlines, you know, and I've seen your profile, and maybe it's a good profile, and then I look at your CV, and it's just like a duck has just done it.
Yes.
It's like, no, I won't even call you, right?
Yeah, it's a very good example. I think another thing is also having 2 shots of the CV.
Yeah.
Your CV is like, I've done 1, 2, 3, 4, and that's it.
That's done, yeah.
It's not okay. Yes, you're saying it should not be too long, but also it should not be too short. Too short meaning it really does not represent what you've done. So all you've done is that from 2010 to 2020, I was at Empower. What were you doing at Empower? What exactly were your achievements at Empower? So it leaves me not aware, because a salesperson in one company can do very different things compared to a salesperson in another company.
Yes.
So you really have to at least share a bit about your duties and more on your achievements. What difference did you make while you're there? Because, for example, sometimes you see a CV and you're like, this candidate does not fit for all. But you unfortunately meet them and have a conversation with them and you're like, wow, this is a very good candidate.
Yeah.
But
they haven't represented themselves
in a CV.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah. I think the most important part is when you're talking about a certain experience, you need to pick maybe 3 or 5, like, your main responsibilities. Okay? So maybe as a project coordinator, maybe I do, I look for talent, right? I look for candidates, I look for talent in the market. Maybe one day there was a meeting and then I brought in tea and coffee because maybe the person who does it isn't there. I'm not going to then include that on my duties and say I deliver tea and coffee, you know, just so it's long.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't mean that when you've done so much, then you're qualified, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It just has to explain, like, think of it as your the thing that's going to explain about what you're doing when you're not there.
Because
you can't go there and say, no, what I wrote here, what I actually meant was this and this. What I meant by this was this, like, no, not me. Another thing that I don't like about CVs, and when I say I don't like, I mean, like, just don't do it.
Yes.
Is having, like, personal references or, like, just references that don't make sense. Yeah. So say I worked at Empower or I worked at Netflix, and then I put a reference of my mother, you know, and my father,
yes,
and my sister.
Yes.
What do you think?
And you don't even say that. The thing is, people think we are not smart enough. Because they'll put we're recruiting. We're smart.
Yeah.
They'll put a name and a title and an organization, and they've not worked there. They've not done a project with those people, they're not their clients.
Yeah.
There's no interaction between what they say they were doing and that referee.
True.
So in my mind, I'm like, why? Why are you doing this? Who is this? Is this your parent? Is this your uncle?
Yeah.
Or someone was doing very junior self and they put a CEO as their referee. And you're like,
they probably don't even know what the CEO is like.
Yes.
Yeah.
And probably the CEO don't know they exist.
They don't even know they work there. So maybe let's take a moment, tell them what is a referee.
So a referee is someone who can speak of your professional ability.
Okay.
So it's someone who any person who is interested to hire you can reach out to them and get a kind of proof that you can do the work.
Okay.
So this needs to be someone either who you've been reporting to before, and it should not be a friend at work. Lightness, can you be my referee?
Yeah, it's like, it's not a Valentine's Day.
Yes. It should not
serious.
It should not be a friend at work.
Yeah.
It should be someone you're reporting to, someone who's at a higher position than you, or someone you've collaborated in a project
for achievements, it's good also to include some achievements. Yeah.
Yes.
Of course, you see, it shouldn't be too long, but don't be modest. If you've done something great in the company, if you've increased the sales of the company, I mean, it's good for us to know. You know, especially for salespeople, we want to see achievements. Yeah.
Not salespeople only, but people who are target driven.
Exactly.
Yes. So if you're target driven, if you're strategy driven, I would say if you've achieved that, definitely prove that you've reached your target, you've exceeded your target, or you've caused a change in an organization.
Yeah.
You came in and you introduced a new system,
yeah.
a new way of doing things. Definitely, those are the things people are looking for. People are looking for game changes. People are looking for people who can come in and add value. And you don't have to wait for an interview to communicate that.
Yeah,
the sooner you show that I'm a game changer,
the better.
I went to Empower and they did not have reporting systems, and I introduced a new reporting system.
Yeah.
Shout yourself out.
Yeah. And I think maybe something good to note is that achievements and duties are not synonyms. Yeah. Like you can't say your achievement is that you did a profit and loss account and yet you're an accountant, like that's your job. You know, those are your duties.
You did the bare minimum.
You did, that's not an achievement. So an achievement is something over and above, or something that wasn't there and you introduced, or something that you improved, something that you can be proud of, you know? You can't stand and say, I'm proud of I've done my profit and loss account. Well, that's your job. And then maybe speak a little bit about the cliché.
Another thing also in a CV is cliché, saying, especially in profile, I have vast experience in sales.
Mm-hmm.
I am extremely time conscious.
Mm.
I am the best in project management.
I'm the best there is.
I am the best there is. I have extreme marketing
skills.
You know, it's like you're typing yourself out.
It sounds fine.
It sounds fine. It sounds nice.
But there's like no substance.
There's no substance to it.
Yeah.
How can I know you're the best
mm-hmm.
when it's just one document?
Yeah.
Instead of saying I am the best salesperson, if you are awarded, if you are recognized at your former place, you can highlight it an achievement. Like my achievement, this is the certificate I was given.
Mm-hmm.
If you have extreme experience in time management and you reached your monthly target in 2 weeks, say that. So instead of using fancy, nice words to explain yourself, give concrete example. Instead of saying I have vast experience in sales, you can say I have 5 experience in sales, 5 years. So I can already say, 5 years is a long time.
Yeah.
But what is vast?
In what industry?
In what industry?
No.
How is vast?
The beauty of our CV builder is that when you're doing your profile, it actually tells you.
Yes.
Give an example of whatever it is that you're talking about. I'm not going to tell you too much, but it does tell you, give me that. Like, it literally guides you.
Of what you want and how to do it. I think you should just use this.
I think we should just end the talk and just say, hey guys, use the CV Builder so you have a good CV.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the CV Builder helps you to not do all of these things you're talking about. Now, the best thing about the CV Builder is that it has one font. Yes?
Yes.
It has the correct, if you write a wrong word, it will tell you that this is wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Which I think many people don't. They don't even pay attention to my grammar.
Just
word.
No.
They don't. Because then it's like you have like wrong spellings in the CV.
Mm-hmm.
You have, you know, the times if you change one letter of a word, it means something
different.
So different.
Check your grammar.
Exactly. Like before you send out your CV, before you say, okay, this is my CV, make sure every spelling is correct. Make
mm-hmm.
sure every word is correct. Make sure the sentence you're writing makes sense, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Don't use like broken English in your CV. You
and
know?
Then in languages say you're very fluent in English.
Wow!
You meet those people, their profile has broken English, and then down their sentence they say it
English
fluent.
Some of them even put stars.
Good.
Like five stars. Okay. I think we've said a lot about what we don't like. Yeah. Maybe let's give a chance for people to ask questions.
Mm-hmm.
Because we've spoken a lot and maybe we've attacked a lot of people. I'm hoping a lot of people are thinking, okay, let me go and use the CV Builder now because my CV is not so good.
Yes.
So I'm hoping this has pushed you to use this.
Mm-hmm.
So
Okay, so there are some questions that we've received earlier this week.
Okay.
So one person says, does the CV builder solve my grammatical errors? So what do you think about that? Okay. Or what do you have to say about that?
You know, it does. It solves all your, like there is no, you can't have a word error, a grammatical error without CV builder, because if you write a wrong word, it will
analyze.
However, maybe there's some companies that maybe they've been named after someone's name and maybe it's actually not in the dictionary in that sense. Probably will tell you it's wrong, but you can ignore and keep that. Mm-hmm. But just don't, like, here we've told, the worst thing is when someone misspells the employer's name. How do you misspell your own employer's name? Why would you do that? So yes, to answer the question, yes, it does assist with that.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Thank you so much. That's a good question. Answer. Mm-hmm. So we have another question from Jacqueline.
Okay.
She says, can you add a sample CV on your website for reference? So I know you've been talking about how to get a good CV, how to get the perfect CV. Now Jacqueline is saying, is there a way to have a sample? She's thinking of us having a sample CV on our website just for reference.
So Jacqueline, the CV builder is a sample CV. Right. But it is a sample CV, you can edit right there live.
Mm-hmm.
So we have three templates for now, more are coming. All you have to do is log into www.empowered.co.tz. At the top, you choose CV Builder and you choose the template you think you like and you can edit the information. So it's already, it tells you exactly what should you put, gives you tips of how to put, and there's an example of exactly what you can write.
Yeah.
I don't think there's more you need.
Like, should we put a sample? No. Should we? We'll think about it. We'll think about it. But then we've already given you the tools. You just have to go on our website.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not a registered candidate, please just register. It's such a quick process.
Mm-hmm.
And then another thing about our website is when you are registering and you're creating your profile, please try by all means to fill out everything there.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because what the system does is, if there is a position that we are working on,
mm-hmm.
and it matches with what you put in your profile, the system will actually tell
you,
it will alert you,
mm-hmm.
there is this job, please apply for it because it matches your skills.
Yes.
But if you don't put everything in your profile, you're going to miss out. And even
yes.
when we're searching, we won't see that.
Yes.
So trying to fill out everything in your profile will really help as well. That's
yes.
just like a binary.
Okay. The final question, tricky but also interesting, from Ahmed.
Mm-hmm.
He says, am I guaranteed a job offer after using CV Builder?
Okay. I'm just going to take a moment. Let's take a moment. Everybody just think about that question for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see how those two things, you know.
So how Empower works
mm-hmm.
is that we start from the client side of
mm-hmm.
things. And then we have different clients who come to us looking for different employees. So they already say, I'm looking for a finance manager.
Very specific.
I'm looking for a graduate trainee.
Yeah.
And this and this and this is what I'm looking for.
Mm-hmm.
And what we do from there now is to go to our portal where as a candidate you're registered
exactly.
and you have your nice CV there.
Mm-hmm.
And we do a quick screening of those candidates who have applied
yeah.
and then we suggest those candidates who will see our fit
mm-hmm.
to our client.
Yeah.
So, though you're not guaranteed a job offer if you use the CV Builder, what you're guaranteed is two things. Number one, you will be in our system, in our database, hence you'll be alerted when you have opportunities that
mm-hmm.
fit your profile and your experience. Two, you have a good CV which you can apply to other job applications.
Yeah.
Hence, it will increase your chances of landing an interview and hopefully
a job.
Yes.
I think that's something you didn't say. You can literally download the CV off
yes.
the website
and use it anywhere.
Anywhere you want.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe it does guarantee you a job because then you can use it to find
a job.
Mm-hmm. I think that's all the questions we have at the moment. Maybe just for us to reiterate how people can register, it's www.empower.co.tz. Please follow us on our social media pages as well. We are Empower Limited on all social, across all platforms, Instagram.
to help and assist our candidates
exactly.
stand out and